with the help of the slotted line, we will move the slotted line to get the maximum value, that is around 0 dB. So move the slotted line very slowly and set the value at around 0 dB. So, and if you don't get the value at around 0 dB with the help of the slotted line, you can also use this coarse and fine switch to get the 0 dB value. Now after that, again move the slotted line very slowly to get the minimum value in the SWR meter. So we can see that the minimum value here is -4.80 dB. So this will be our D1. So with the help of the slotted section, we can get this value. We can see that the value is around 10.2. Sorry, the value is around 10.1. Now this will be our D1. Now we will need the value of D2. So again, move the slotted line very slowly and get the next minimum value in the SWR meter. So we can see it is increasing, and now it is decreasing again. So this is our minimum value, -4.70, and with the help of the slotted section, we can see that the value is around 12.2. Now with the help of this formula, lambda g equals to 2 into d1 minus d2, we can get the value of lambda g. So this is the setup for measurement of high VSWR. So to measure the high VSWR, first we need to set the maximum power. So I have set here the current is 29, and this is the beam voltage 310. Now from here we also need to set the maximum power by moving this plunger. Now keep this variable attenuator at no penetration, means no attenuation. Now this is the slotted line, and we need to adjust the probe to get the maximum power. Also adjust this probe. Also this is, also adjust this, this is in maximum penetration position. So we can see that our, this is the waveform, and the amplitude or the power of the signal is around 100. So to measure the high VSWR, you need to set it around 100 or more than 100. With the help of this slotted line, we need to get the minimum value in the SWR meter. So move the probe along the slotted line so that we can get the minimum value. So this is the minimum value I have got. So now with the help of these two switch, we need to set the value around 3 dB. So I as we can see that we are not getting 3 dB, so we need to change the range for this. Again set the value at minimum position, that is now switch the range to 60 dB and move the probe to get the minimum value at this range. Now we can see that this is the minimum value that we have got. Now with the help of these two switch, we will set this around 3 dB. So this is minus 3 dB. With the help of VSWR meter, gain coarse switch and gain fine switch, adjust the power at around minus 3 dB. So this is the power. Now move the slotted line along the left side till we get the maximum power, that is 0 dB. So move the slotted line towards the left side. So this is the 0 dB and the distance is, we can see here from the slotted line, it is 10.3. Now we need to move this probe towards the right side, and again we need to get the power at 0 dB, that is the maximum power. So move very slowly the probe, and this is from here we can get the distance, that is 10.2. So my S1 is 10.3 and S2 is 10.2. So with the help of lambda g by pi into S1 minus S2, we can get the SWR value, which is 13.05. Measurement of low and medium VSWR. First, keep this SS tuner probe in no penetration position. Now we will need to move this slotted line to get the maximum value in the VSWR meter. So the maximum value we have got is 3.0. 3.40 dB. So now with the help of this two knob, we need to set this around 0 dB. So this is around 0 dB. So around 0 dB, the VSWR value will be 1. So this is, you can see, 1 SWR. Now we need to move this slotted line to get the minimum position, sorry, minimum value in SWR meter. So this is the minimum value we have received. So now this is the SWR value we can see directly in the SWR meter. This is 1.12. Now press the mode again in dB mode. Now again move the slotted line to get maximum value, that is 0 dB, almost 0 dB. So now we need to penetrate the SS tuner probe. Now we will again move the slotted line to get the minimum value in the SWR meter. So move the probe very slowly to get the minimum value. So we can see that our minimum value is around 2 dB. So press this switch, SWR switch, to see the SWR ratio. This is 1.27. Now press this switch again to get back in dB mode. So we can see that as the probe is penetrating, the SWR ratio is also increasing. Now move the probe slowly to get the maximum value, that is 0 dB. And now we will again penetrate the probe. Now move the slotted line to get minimum value in the SWR meter. So we can see that our minimum value is minus 2.10 dB. Press the SWR switch to see the SWR ratio, and we can see it is 1.29. So as we are seeing, the ratio is increasing as the probe is penetrating. Now press the switch again in dB mode, and we will move the slotted line to get the maximum value, that is 0 dB. Now we will penetrate this SS tuner. Now we will move the slotted line to get the minimum value is SWR meter. We can see that the minimum value is around 3.40 4050 dB, and we will see the SWR value directly in the SWR meter. We can see it is 1.52.